Surgeries on infants for tongue tie have really jumped in recent years, but not all of those surgeries are necessary. For parents who are having trouble breastfeeding and who are looking for solutions, go to your pediatrician first. Hi, I'm Jenny Thomas, and I'm a general pediatrician. I'm also a breastfeeding and lactation medicine specialist, and I'm the lead author on the AAP's new clinical report on ankyloglossia in breastfed infants. Ankyloglossia happens because the tongue doesn't move the way that we need it to. It happens because the floor of the mouth anchors the tongue, and so when you try to elevate it, it doesn't work as well. People call it tongue tie because it seems like it's tied to the bottom of the mouth. The procedure for correcting tongue tie involves lifting the tongue and removing the connective tissue that's underneath the tongue. We just cut it so that that tongue is released and is not stuck to the floor of the mouth any longer. The amount of procedures being done for tongue tie have exponentially grown over the past several years. At least part of that is because we've had so many more breastfeeding families in the past couple of years. And there's some difficulties a lot of times with breastfeeding relationships. And sometimes that procedure looks so tempting, like it's going to fix everything. And it may not do that. We have also seen that there are pressures on social media for families where if you haven't gotten your kid checked for ties, that maybe you're not doing everything for that relationship. What we are hoping is that you go see your pediatrician to help with those breastfeeding difficulties. We're not saying that tongue tie is never the problem. There are certainly kids who will benefit from having this procedure, but there are a lot of different possibilities and we need to explore all of them. We can do that with your pediatrician in the medical home.